Anthony's presentation is on dowsing as a support for feng shui. He will also be teaching this subject in July here on the Gold Coast. Please have a look on the table outside for more information. Give Anthony a wonderful warm welcome.
Good afternoon, I'm your bookend for today, so you might be a little bit drowsy, particularly after that bowel biology talk. We can feel what's going on in here with all the electrodes and everything else. So how about I get you all to just stand up for a minute and just get a little bit of blood flowing. So just maybe just moving your wrists like this and maybe just pulsing with like that. And in yoga we call this, careful if you've got jewelry on your chest, we call this the yoga cup of coffee. Not too hard, just for a couple of minutes, and it'll kind of wake you up. Just keep doing that for a second, and I'll... There is salt and vodka in here, so don't breathe it too deeply. Thank you. I'm here today to talk about dowsing as a support for feng shui. So in no way am I belittling the importance of feng shui and how important that is.
Thank you.
But I also believe that it can have support in other areas, and of course such topics as, you know, healthy home, non-toxic home are really important for us to have an understanding of. And dowsing, I think, is a very, very powerful tool that we can use to support our feng shui. Not to replace it, but to really support it, possibly even take us deeper into it. This little thing, here we go. So the ancient wisdom of dowsing can be a great tool for every feng shui practitioner, helping to solve difficult and unexplained issues when consulting. Feng shui doesn't always provide all the answers. Some researchers and teachers say feng shui has everything that you need. It does. And one of the most important things about that I would suggest, well, just, you know, there may be people in the room who don't understand what dowsing is. So dowsing is a way of connecting deeply in with a side of ourselves that we don't commonly use. And a slide will come up in a minute and I'll explain what it is. But there's a number of primary forms. There's many, many different tools, but the most common kind of tools are dowsing rods, which can be very, very simple pieces of wire, or slightly more complicated ones like this made by the very, very famous, now passed over dowser, Hamish Miller. Mm-hmm. And the other common way to douse is using a pendulum. So I've actually checked in a little bit earlier and got permission. Within dowsing, there's an etiquette about should I, can I, series of questions that we use to say, is it appropriate that I douse with this subject? And so, just as a very, very brief example, see if I pick up the same thing. I doused earlier to see if there was any geopathic stress, any earth lines, so I might see a clearing of seats come through the middle here in a minute. Short-term stays in geopathic stress aren't really going to hurt you. So I'm picking up a minor kind of line here. It's not overly strong. One of the nice things about these dowsing rods, they've got paddles on them so you can actually feel the strength of them. So I'm picking up something here. And it's not very long, so it's kind of like about here. So if anybody wants to move, they're welcome to right now. I also doused, but was there any other negative energies within this space? And I got a whole lot of yes. Did I get much in terms of, was there much in the way of natural negative energies in here? Not particularly, apart from this geopathic line through here. I got a big response, is there any man-made negative energies in here? And I'm kind of like, well, yeah, of course there is. There's a lot of, you know, there's what that whole lecture is just about. Of course those energies are in here. And I also doubt whether there's any spirit energy in here. I thought, yes, there was. Did my cleansing this morning.
Yeah.
And one of the ladies actually saw, you know, a mind's eye vision of an indigenous apparition that appeared in here that was quite strong and quite pleased. Part of what I did with my cleansing was using click sticks and actually invited a representation of that to support us today. So we have got a mixture of kind of energies in here. And that's what dowsing is so great at, is it can tell us what else is here. So there's all sorts of tools for dowsing, from bobbers to pendulums and to various kinds of rods, to sticks and all sorts of things that we can use. So to understand what dowsing is, there's nothing magic about your pendulum, despite the fact you might have gorgeous little numbers like this and got amethyst and quartz and all that sort of stuff. It's really only adding to my personal connection to my pendulum or to my rod. You know, a lot of the time I just use coat hanger wire. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. I just happen to have some fancy ones from one of my teachers as well. So where's the power in dowsing? The real power is, as I say to people, our conscious brains can process around about 4, or if you're a brilliant musician, maybe 5 different pieces of information can be processed in our conscious mind at one time. Our subconscious, otherwise known perhaps as our intuition, can process around about 40,000 pieces of information at one time. So if I'm consciously trying to recognize what energy is in the environment, I'm only picking up certain signals. If I'm using my subconscious via dowsing, I can process 40,000 different pieces of information that are surging through my consciousness that I can potentially pick up on. Now, the only reason that some people can do this better than others is they have the confidence to do it. Mm-hmm. It's taken me many years to find the confidence to douse well. As you know, you can see the thing with the iceberg that gives you a little bit of a visual clue as to what I'm talking about. And no, it's not a new age thing. You know, look at that quote from Albert Einstein. I know very well that many scientists consider dowsing, just put my glasses on so I can read as they do astrology, it's a type of ancient superstition. According to my convictions, this is unjustified. The dowsing rod is a simple instrument which shows the uncanny reaction of the human nervous system to certain factors which are unknown to us at this time. Dowsing is not new age. Dowsing is not just a Western modality. Now, this is really important because some people might say, well, look, Feng Shui holds everything that we need.